Haleluya, Bwana Yesu asifiwe sana. Kwa majina ni mke wa mchungaji Mark, nimeokoka na Yesu ni Bwana. Maisha yangu yote nimejitolea huyu Yesu na nikamuishie, maana kwake kuna uzima. I just want to appreciate every one of you that held our hands up for supporting us on our fundraising that we held last week. On this altar, we were able to raise quite a good amount of cash, and we have been able to do a few things over the week. We have decorated this church, as you can see, if you can see. We have bought flower faces, we've done our curtains, and everything is on the progress. We are still doing it. And if you are out there, you feel you don't have this opportunity to bypass you, please, you can still support us. We are on the ongoing. We are still doing several things in the church as women. And so I just want to appreciate you. And again, I just want to remind you of our services this day. From 9 to 10, we have our intercessory hour here at Temple of Worship Ministry. We are just located behind Casmart Supermarket. And from 10 to 12:30, we have our main service. You just can't afford to miss these services. On this altar, I tell you, many things are happening. Our jobs are changing. Our situations are changing. People are getting babies over here. God is healing people on this altar. And if you are out there, just come and test the Lord that He is good. And you will know that the Lord speaks on this altar. And for this time, I want to welcome the man of God, the international speaker. I know He has a word for us this day. I am ready and ready to listen to what the Lord has for us this day. I want you to do me a favor, as you've always done. Please be my usher out there. Subscribe to this YouTube channel. And even share, like, comment something. And even like. Let us be known to the world. And for this doing, the Lord can never leave you behind. You can only soar and soar and soar. So this is the right time to welcome the man of God, Pastor Mark. I am just ready. God bless you and shalom.
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Welcome once again to our service today. We love to minister to you by the grace of God. And we are happy that you have been our partner, and we thank God for you. And once again this morning, we want to bring the word of God to you by the grace of God. Amen. As Mom has said, we want to say a special thank you to them that supported us during our fundraiser last Sunday. That was spearheaded by Women Ministry, the church. We've done well. That if you still want to partake, please use the number 0704-519-274. And the Lord is going to bless you. Alternatively, you can send direct to a mom if you have her number, and the Lord is going to bless you. Amen. We want to go straight to the Word of God. And today, I want to read several portions of Scripture. If you have your Bible, go with me to the book of Genesis, chapter number 4. Genesis, chapter number 4. I'll read from verse 1. The Bible says, Adam made love to his wife, Eve, and she became pregnant and gave birth to Cain. And she said, with the help of the Lord, I have brought forth a man. Later she gave birth to his brother, Abel, and Abel kept flocks. Cain worked the soil. In the course of time, Cain brought some of the fruit of the soil as an offering to the Lord. And Abel also brought an offering, 5 portions from some of the firstborn of his flock. The Lord looked with favor on Abel and his offering, but on Cain and his offering, he did not look with favor. So Cain was very angry and his face was downcast. Then the Lord said to Cain, why are you angry? Why is your face downcast? If you do what is right, will you not be accepted? But if you do not do what is right, sin is crouching at your door. It desires to have you, but you must rule over it. Now Cain said to his brother Abel, let's go out to the field. While they were in the field, Cain attacked his brother Abel and killed him. Then the Lord said to Cain, where is your brother Abel? I do not know, he replied. Am I my brother's keeper? The Lord said, what have you done? Listen, your brother's blood cries out to me from the ground. Now you are under a curse and are driven from the ground, which is open its mouth to receive your brother's blood from your hand. When you work on the ground, it will no longer yield its fruits for its crops for you. You will be restless, a reckless wanderer on the earth. Cain said to the Father, to the Lord, my punishment is more than I can bear. Today you are driving me from the land, and I will be hidden from your presence. I will be a restless wanderer on the earth, and whoever finds me will kill me. Go to the book of Proverbs, chapter number 6. Proverbs, chapter number 6. We are going to read very fast. Verse 16, the Bible says, make a roof. Proverbs chapter number 6, verse number 16. The Bible says, there are six things that the Lord hates, seven that are detestable to him. Haughty eyes, a lying tongue, hands that shed innocent blood, a heart that devises wicked plans, feet that are quick to rush to evil, false witness that pours out lies, and a person who stirs up a conflict in the community. Then we go to the same book, verse 27, Proverbs chapter 27, verse number 4. Anger is cruel and fury overwhelming, but who can stand before jealousy? Then finally, let's go to the book of James. We're reading very fast. You can write down, you'll follow later. James chapter number 3 and verse 16. The Bible says, for where you have envy and selfish ambition, then you fight disorder and every evil practice. Father, in the name of Jesus, I pray that, Lord, as I share your word this morning, that your spirit is going to be in me, that I may tell your people what you intend them to hear. I pray that, Lord, as I humble myself, that this morning you will use me as a vessel. But let the glory, let the honor come back to you. I give you honor and I give you praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, I want to talk to you today. I want to teach about the spirit, fighting the spirit of jealousy. Fighting the spirit of jealousy. Now, this is one spirit that is dominant in the community. In the communities that we live in, with the people that we live with, jealousy is one common thing that is central. Jealousy is as bad as witchcraft. If you live with somebody who is jealous, then you will understand that everything that you do becomes a hindrance to them. And this spirit manifests in many aspects of our life. Sometimes we are able to recognize jealousy. Sometimes we're not able to do that. And jealousy can go to the extreme to cause death. Like we have read in the story of Cain and Abel. There is nothing that Abel did which was wrong. he just offered a sacrifice that the Lord accepted. And because of that sacrifice, then Cain had a problem with Abel. This is jealousy. This is not, he did not hate his brother, but the jealousy in him is a spirit of the devil. The jealousy in him caused him to start hating the brother, and eventually he killed him because he realized that his offering was receiving favor from the Lord. And that alone caused him to hate his brother. And this is the same thing that happens today. Jealousy has been mentioned in Proverbs chapter number 6 as one of the things that the Lord hates. He hates jealousy. So the people that are jealous have something with the Lord to deal with, because God hates jealousy people. So people that are hooked to being jealous, people that look for opportunity to be jealous, God hates them, hates that spirit. And it's common, let me tell you, this spirit is so common that we live with people that are jealous. We live with people that are saved, but they are jealous. We live with people that are close to us, but are jealous. We live with people that probably love us, but they are jealous because you're doing something that looks like a competition to them. It poses a threat to them. There are people that are jealous of their spouse progress. There are people that are jealous because their wives are doing well. There are people that are jealous because their husbands are doing well. There are people that are jealous because their children, their kids are doing well. You can imagine how jealous it can get, how bad it can get. Sometimes people become jealous of their sons. They look more handsome than their father, and the father starts having a problem. Sometimes ladies are not able to stand the beauty of their daughter. They become jealous. This is how bad it can get. But the spirit of the devil. So I want to bring a way that we can fight jealousy as a people. There is a way that we can fight jealousy. Let me tell you, jealousy does not add anything into somebody's life. The fact that Cain called, killed Abel did not bring favor to Cain. This is one thing that people that are jealous do not understand. The fact that you have an issue with somebody, the fact that you have a problem with somebody, does not mean if you eliminate that person, then that problem will end. If you hate somebody, hate somebody because they are rich, even if you eliminate them, you will not become them. You will continue with your poverty. And this is a technique that the enemy uses. So why are people jealous about each other, against each other? Sometimes people are jealous against each other because somebody is knowledgeable. When you become knowledgeable, when you become bright, some people will start hating you. Some people will become jealous because they are not able to do it like you. When you sit in class with somebody and they are scoring everything and somebody else is not scoring, a spirit of jealousy can actually originate from there. Some people are jealous of others because they are successful. The fact that somebody is doing a good business, they are earning money, somebody else is trying the same business, they are not earning money, jealousy comes into play. Some people are jealous because other people are smart, just wearing clothes. The fact that people are wearing better clothes, the fact that people are good, better shape, if there is anything like that, people can become jealous of that. Just the mere fact that somebody is doing things in a better way. The mere fact that somebody has a better job than the other can become jealous. This is the spirit of the devil. There is nobody who has caused you not to have a better job. The fact that somebody else has a better job, they have not prevented you from having a better job. So you need to understand some of the things that people hate others because of has nothing to do with their
to be hated. It is the doing of the Lord. And the doing of the Lord sometimes becomes, brings jealousy. The doing of the Lord, the favor, that M or A, that favor can bring jealousy to people that are having less favor. Some jealousy is very petty. People can hate others because they have a new dress. You know, you just buy a new dress and people just hate you. Somebody has favor, somebody just hates you. Somebody has done a hairstyle. But somebody else hates them too at the saloon. You know, there is no good reason why you start hating somebody because they have a unique hairstyle. You can go to the saloon. You should not hate somebody because they have more money. But hatred comes very often because somebody has more money than the other. And hatred is such that even the person who is jealous sometimes does not realize it is jealousy. It's a spirit that dominates and camouflages. It looks like they are happy, but they are not. The fact that somebody lives in a better place, the fact that somebody has been promoted, brings jealousy. The fact that somebody can actually communicate better, the fact that somebody can preach better, the fact that somebody can articulate issues better, brings jealousy to people. The fact that somebody can organize people better than the other becomes jealousy. It's a spirit that is spread in all aspects of our lives. People are jealous of others because they have been promoted. People are jealous of others because they have children. Imagine. Because they have children. They have given birth. They are expecting, you know, people are jealous of that. This is the spirit of the devil. People are jealous of others because they have a husband. They have their wife. They have a girlfriend. They have a boyfriend. You know? People become jealous. Many things in life that we live brings jealousy. But I came so that we can look at how we can deal with the spirit of jealousy. Because it's a spirit that is dominating a society that we live in today. The spirit of jealousy will prevent people from going to heaven. People that are jealous often do things that do not please God. And things that do not please God is sin, and sin will not enter heaven. And so I want us to understand how we can fight the spirit of the devil, this spirit of jealousy, which is so widespread. I don't know whether I am speaking to somebody. I don't know whether we are living in a society that we can see people that are jealous. I don't know whether we are living with people that are envious, jealousy about other people's families, envious about other people's cars that they drive, envious about other people's houses that they are put up, envious, jealousy about other people's progress. This is a devil that I want to deal with today by the grace of God. So what happens when people are jealous? Jealousy brings hatred. Watu wanachukiana. Jealousy brings a lot of hatred between people. People hate one another. People start disliking one another because of jealousy. Not because people have wronged them, but because the spirit of the devil, the spirit of jealousy in them. So jealousy brings hatred. Number two, jealousy can bring sabotage. You could be planning something, but simply because somebody doesn't want the other person to shine, they plan a sabotage. They start bringing things to stop the work that the person is doing. They start bringing things to stop the progress that the other person is doing. They start bringing, even in groups where we live in the community, if you are bringing good ideas, people might actually sabotage the idea, not because they don't like it, but they are jealous because you are able to bring out good ideas. This is the spirit of the devil. can bring sabotage. Number four, jealousy can bring evil schemes. People start scheming downfall of others. At your place of work, because you are progressing, your favor with the bosses, your favor with the people that you work with, people start scheming your downfall. How they are going to fix you so that you can fall. Let me tell you, it doesn't matter the people, the person might fall, but it is the spirit of the devil. It is the satanic spirit, and that spirit is going to catch up with the person who has it soon or later. You may scheme for somebody not to be promoted, but let me tell you, you may get the promotion, but it will catch up with you at some point, and you are going to face the wrath of God. Number four, the spirit of jealousy can cause death. There are people that have killed because of jealousy. There are people in politics that have killed because of jealousy. There are people in the church that have killed. I said in the church, that have killed because of jealousy. There are people out there, business rival, that has resorted to death. Not because they have taken your business, but because the spirit of jealousy is so dominant to the extent that they eliminate other person. Jealousy in a relationship leads to death. The love triangle. You know, you hear of love triangle. This is jealousy. It's just being nicknamed by the media people. It's just being nicknamed by people who know English. But this is jealousy triangle. People are jealous about each other. People are jealous because you're going to be married by somebody else and they have not been married. People are jealous because you're going to marry somebody that they have a wish to marry, and this causes death. People kill one another because of jealousy. But how do we overcome jealousy? This is the most important part of this message, because we need, now we understand that we are living in a community that is full of jealousy. So how do we overcome this? How do you overcome jealousy? Because I know everyone that is watching me, at one point you have realized that you have been affected by this thing in one way or the other. So how do we deal with it? Number one, stay prayerful. If you are a prayerful Christian, if you keep praying, prayer brings godliness. Godliness brings righteousness. If you are a righteous man, then jealousy has no part in your life. But if you stay a prayerless life, then the spirit of the devil can enter you easily. So stay prayerful. Kaa kwa maombi. Usikae kama mtu hajaokoka. Usikae kama mtu hujui Mungu. Kaa kwa maombi. Na hii roho ya shetani haitakuingia. Hii roho ya shetani itashindwa, kwa sababu hii roho inataka kuingia kwa mtu yeyote. Number two, appreciate the success of the other people. This is very godly. You need to be able to appreciate and celebrate other people. When people are succeeding, when your children are succeeding, when your friend is succeeding, when your wife is succeeding, when your husband is succeeding, celebrate them. When you celebrate them, then you are inviting the spirit in that person into your life. When you invite the spirit into your life, then you are also going to be successful. So don't frown. Usikunje uso kwa sababu jirani yako anajenga nyumba mzuri. Celebrate them, visit them, encourage them to continue doing the good thing. And that spirit is going to enter you. Number three, aim to improve. You can improve from where you are. If you feel like the people that you went to school with are doing better than you, you can improve your life. You can improve by going back to school. You can improve yourself by doing better. You can improve yourself, but you know, you can better who you are. The other number is seek to understand how they did it. You know, instead of hating them, ask them how they did it. Instead of just being jealous about them, ask them how they are doing their business. Let them give you tips on how to do it. Instead of hating somebody because they have a girlfriend, because they have a boyfriend, because they have a wife, ask them how they did it. And then try, because that spirit can enter into you if you genuinely seek their advice. And this is going to help you to be a better person. The other number is trust God for lifting. These things come from the Lord. Success comes from the Lord. Success does not come from the devil. Money does not come from the devil. Promotion does not come from the devil. They come from God. So trust God for your own lifting. Don't start hating other people. Don't start being jealous about other people. Trust God for your own personal lifting. And God is going to help you. The other number, pray for the other people. Don't be selfish. Every time you go before the Lord, don't just pray about yourself. Pray even for the other people. Pray for your neighbor. Pray for that person who doesn't have food. Pray for that person about a promotion. Pray for that person who is struggling with a disease. Pray for them. Don't be selfish about prayer. When you pray for the other, then God is going to lift you to a higher level. In Jesus' name. And finally, if you have found that spirit is in you, how to overcome it, you need to repent. Repent before the Lord. Repentance brings you back to the factory settings. For those that have smartphones, you go back to the factory setting. So if you repent your sins today, then God is going to forgive of every sin that you have committed, even the sin of jealousy. And you are going to go back to a righteous man. So I want you to, today, I don't know what you want to do, but I want to pray with people that want to repent. You have been jealous of something. You have been unhappy because of your friend's success. I want you to pray that God is going to help you. I want you to pray that God is going to forgive you, and you are going to march up to the next level by the grace of God. Amen. I want to pray with those people. You are there, you are saying, Pastor, I want to repent. I have been jealous. I didn't know it was jealous, but now I know I've been jealous. I want you to pray this prayer after me. Say, Father, in the name of Jesus, I repent of my sins, the sins of jealousy, sins of hatred. Sometimes it has happened without my knowledge, but now I know it is the spirit of the devil. I repent today. In the name of Jesus, help me, Lord. Forgive me my sins. Make me a new creation in Jesus' name. If you have prayed that prayer, God has forgiven you. Do not go back to being jealous. Be careful with what you do, and God is going to bless you. I want also to pray for people that are saying, Pastor, I do not have a personal relationship with God. I want to give my life to the Lord. I want to help you to be in good standing with the Lord. You are there, you want to be saved. Say, pray this prayer before me. Say, Lord Jesus, I come to you. I repent my sins. Forgive me, Lord. Save my life. Write my name in the Lamb's book of life. I pray this in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, if you are praying that prayer, you are saved. God has saved you. Get yourself a church that believes in the Bible. And when you do that, God is going to bless you. Don't forget to tune in next Sunday. We're going to come to you again with the word of God to bless you and to give you hope. God bless you. See you next time. Shalom.